गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ क्लास 12 पॉलिटिकल साइंस वंस अगेन हियर. सो स्टूडेंट्स, वी वर कंटिन्यूइंग विद द थर्ड चैप्टर, दैट इज यूएस हेजेमनी इन द वर्ल्ड पॉलिटिक्स, एंड वी हैड फिनिश्ड आवर फाइव पार्ट्स, एंड नाउ आई एम स्टार्टिंग विद द सिक्स्थ पार्ट. बट बिफोर आई स्टार्ट माई टॉपिक, दैट इज कॉन्स्टेंट्स ऑन अमेरिकन पावर, आई वुड लाइक टू टेल यू दैट इन द पार्ट फाइव वी रेड अबाउट द हेजेमनी ऑफ अमेरिका एज अ हार्ड पावर, एज अ स्ट्रक्चरल पावर एंड द सॉफ्ट पावर. दैट इज आफ्टर द डिसइंटीग्रेशन ऑफ यूएसएसआर इन 1991, इट वॉज द सोल सुपर पावर विच वॉज गवर्निंग द वर्ल्ड ऑल ओवर इन ऑल द स्फीयर्स. इफ यू टॉक ऑफ मिलिट्री, इफ यू टॉक ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स, इफ यू टॉक कल्चरल और आइडियोलॉजिकली. सो नाउ, वर देर एनी कॉन्स्टेंट्स? तो आई वुड लाइक टेल यू द मीनिंग ऑफ वट आर द कॉन्स्टेंट्स ऑन अमेरिकन पावर. तो मीनिंग ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट आई रिटन हियर आर लिमिटेशन और रिस्ट्रिक्शन, रुकावट. वट वर द कॉन्स्टेंट्स ऑन द वेज ऑफ अमेरिकन पावर? बिकॉज इट वॉज द सोल पावर, देर वॉज नो अदर कंट्री और नो अदर ग्रुप टू चैलेंज अमेरिकन पावर एट दैट पर्टिकुलर पीरियड ऑफ टाइम. बट देयर वर सर्टेन कॉन्स्टेंट्स और लिमिटेशन और रिस्ट्रिक्शंस विच वर देयर ऑन द वे ऑफ अमेरिका विच वॉज रूलिंग द वर्ल्ड अकॉर्डिंग टू इट्स विश. सो दिस इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट्स. तो वट वर दोज कॉन्स्टेंट्स? देयर आर थ्री टाइप ऑफ कॉन्स्टेंट्स विच वी आर गोइंग टू रीड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. सो सी इट केयरफुली. So the biggest constant on American hegemony lies within its heart. Within its heart means within the heart of hegemony. Because as we know, there was no country, no group which could challenge the power of America at that particular period of time. So the problem or the restrictions which were coming up in front of the American power or the American military forces was within its heart. Despite being the most powerful, US still experienced some constraints in itself as. It was the most powerful, but still it had some constraints which were in itself. What were its itself limitations? Here are three type of limitations I have shown you. First, institutional architecture of the American state. Second, open nature of American society. And the last one is NATO, North Atlantic Treaty Organization. So these are the internal matters of USA. All are in direct connection with the US administration. So we are going to study these three constraints which put a limitation on the power of America after 1991. So first of all, I am taking this part, institution architecture of American state. What was this? Division of power in three branches. Like in India also, we have division of powers between legislative, executive, judiciary. In the same way, if you talk about the institutional architecture or the functioning of the government in America or US, was the power was divided between legislative, executive and judiciary. And when there is a division of power in such type of a government, they keep a check and balance on each other's power. So no one can work or misuse the power or economy within itself, because the other executive or judiciary will keep check on legislative. In the same way, legislative will keep check on executive and judicial system of a particular state. So the division of power of America put a constraint on the working and the functioning and the plans and policies of American power. So this was within its institutional architecture that has maintained the constant in front of the American power. And the second is open nature of American society. If I talk about here of open nature of American society, I am talking here of democracy. And as we know, America was following a system ideology of capitalism. So promotion of these two, democracy and capitalism, led to the open nature of American society. The society in American was open in nature. If you talk of democracy in India or in other developing countries, they are not really a democracy, real democracy. If you talk about America, they maintain that real democratic methods in the country. So political awareness, people are very much involved in the functioning and policies and programs of the government. That what is the government doing? They always keep a check and an eye on the working on functioning of the government. So they are very aware about what is going on in their society and what is government doing for them. What is the motive behind different policies? The second is independent media. The media in American society is independent. Their media is not influenced by any particular person, personalities, or any particular political party. Like in India, we see news channels. Many of the news channels we see and we can analyze that they always favor a particular party. And that is why we can say that it is not an independent media or they are influenced somehow by a particular party or a social group. But in America, these independent media, they question the government, they see the functioning of the government, they keep a check on the functioning of the government and bring all the positive and the correct data for the public or the citizens of American society. And the third is separatism about government methods. These media and people keep a close watch on the hidden objective of government. Whenever a government is taking any steps, any plans, any policies, whenever they have certain plans, there is a hidden objective which is already known by people and media of America. So we can say the open nature and the open nature of society of America is like a constraint on the power of America. So this also acts as a constraint or a limitation on the American power, because people are very much aware, media is very much aware, people know what is happening in the country and why it is happening. So they practice a real democratic method in their American society. So this real open nature of American society also acts as a limitation or restriction on the power of America. So that is why we said here that American hegemony lies within the heart of hegemony. Heart of the hegemony means no other country, no other group from outside is challenging hegemony of US. It is the only internal matters of hegemony or US that are putting constraints on its power. So first I told you the institutional architecture, that is a division of power. They keep a check on the power of US. Second, I told you, open nature of American society. And the third, as you know, when we were doing the Cold War era, I told you this NATO. NATO is a group of 12 states, I told you. And these all 12 states are the allies of or members of US. So these 12 states, which are a group of US, or as a Western world, we can say its full form is Northern Atlantic Treaty Organization. They support and help US to be the hegemon, to have the hegemony all over the world, economically, socially, politically, in military terms, in the trade, commerce, in every field. US has the monopoly all over the world in every field. It's just because we can say because of NATO. All the economy, it is very much dependent on these group for its strong economy. That is why I have written here, Association of 12 States is called NATO, which are the allies of US. Enormous economic benefit of America are associated with NATO. Whenever America needs some economic help or economic support, these 12 members help US as a member of NATO. Alliance can influence American hegemony. This alliance of 12 states can influence American hegemony. If you tell that America is the most powerful, it's, we can say, one of the most important reason for this American hegemony after 1991 is NATO. These 12 states have helped America to maintain its power and authority and monopoly all over the world as a hard power, as a soft power, as well as a structural power. So these are the three constraints you need to study properly. And constraints, I'm telling you again, limitation. What are the elements which put some restriction on the power of a hegemon? That is US. So these three are the constraints.